One, and then pose two. Good, see how this is really nice here? Feel that extension? Here's three. Arm is parallel to the ground. And this is nice and folded. That's a powerful position. You're just gonna go to that, you go to very slow backswing, but I want, by the time you get to three, I want your wrist fully hinged. But start hinging that wrist a little bit more. Okay, good. Wait. I want a better one. You got your old elbow position. Top. Really get them on top. There you go. Much better. Well, that's good. Getting better. I really like your backswing. That left arm. It's very good.
Dodie, I went back and pulled some of your video from a session back in April. I think this was one of the first sessions I had with you. The swing on the left is your golf swing before I began working with you. This was taken right at the beginning of the session. I'm going to take it back until your hands are about waist high. And you can see how you've got this and just a little bit of your elbow's already starting to bend a little bit. And the shaft is still in line with your arm. You haven't really hinged your wrist at all. You haven't even begun to hinge your wrist up in the air. Grant Waite, when his hands get about the same place you are, he's already hinged his wrist as a nice straight arm here. So big difference in how you are using your wrist and hands right there. I'm now going to take you up to the three position. This is when the left arm is parallel to the ground. Here the forearm is parallel to the ground, but not your upper arm. So you started to bend that. And again, you still have not yet begun to hinge your wrist at all. As I take Grant up to where he is, his left arm is parallel to the ground. He almost has a right angle here. Now going to continue on back till you get to the end of your backswing. And you've got a pretty good bend here. That's the end of Grant's backswing. He still has that nice straight arm. You're still on your more on top of your back foot than your front foot. So you've moved your weight quite a bit off that left side. Here you are at impact. Again, you're pretty much on, in fact, you may even have more weight on your back foot than your front foot. You can see how Grant is right on top of his left foot. As I continue you forward, you can see how your left arm bends right there. In fact, both elbows are separating here as you come through. And you're still flat-footed. Still flat-footed. Your back foot is just now beginning to move. But Grant continues through. He keeps both arms extended and straight. His arms are on top of his pectoral muscles. That right arm is very straight. Good position right there. Here Dodie is still in that first session. On the left is before we started changing your swing. And on the right is the beginning of changing your swing. You can see you have a lot more weight on your left foot. In fact, probably even too much. We were working on some drills to get you on that left side to start with. On the left, your backswing, you didn't have much wrist hinge at all. And then by the end of the session, you were starting to hinge your wrist a lot better here. Also, you were keeping your weight on your left side in the end of that first session back in April. Now, even though you were making improvements with your weight shift and in your wrist hinge and your backswing, you still had some issues regarding hitting through the ball with extended arms and keeping those elbows close to each other as you came through. Now, here we are looking at your swing on the left 2 weeks ago in your first practice session at Radar Golf. And you can see how you have a little more weight on your left foot, but you're not exaggerated like you were last spring. So the one on the left is a much better setup. You made progress back in last spring and getting a little bit more weight on your left side, but you were actually exaggerating because of the drills we were doing. And then, but you maintained that feeling. So it looks really good now. You have your left arm bent a little bit, but it almost appears as if you 2 weeks ago you were bending it even more than you were last spring. So even though you made progress in your lower body and keeping your weight on your left side, you were letting that left elbow bend quite a bit. So that was still an issue that you needed to address. Just a little bit past impact, as you go through the ball at impact, you still have the separating elbow issue on both last spring and 2 weeks ago. And last spring and 2 weeks ago, when you got to the ninth position, this is when the right arm gets kind of parallel to the ground, you don't really get that good extension. That's because your elbows, your right elbow and left elbow were starting to bend through impact, and your elbows were separating from each other instead of staying extended through impact. So that was still an issue that you had 2 weeks ago. Dodie on the right is last week compared to 2 weeks ago. And I tell you, your swing is evolving so well. I mean, this setup on the right here with your new elbow position, look how close those elbows are together. That is a pro position right there. That is excellent. Your elbows on the left are still a little bit separating. This is the three position, and when your forearm is parallel to the ground in your current swing, look how much more shaft angle you have. You almost have a right angle there. Whereas you were still haven't got your hands fully loaded yet. You hadn't fully hinged your wrist yet. Really have a good coil. You've got your shoulders turned really well here. You still have your weight on your right side. You've got, left side. So you still have your hip and the back right here. So very good. Now you can see in the four position how you bent this left arm quite a bit, and you have basically a straight arm here, very straight, very powerful position now, because you're using your shoulder as the lever point to pull from, and that's going to give you more power. This swing, you're using your elbow as your lever point. So you have a short lever on the left and a long lever on the right. Here we are on the ninth position. This is a great position here. Big improvement on your swing here. This is when the right arm is supposed to be straight and parallel to the ground. And 2 weeks ago, it was still, you had difficulty extending that right arm straight because you were separating your elbows. Now this arm is just really straight here, and your wrists are crossed here. Elbows are almost touching each other. They're pinching each other. That's excellent. That's a pro position right there. Look at you now compared to Grant Waite. And that's a great extension you have in your arms right there. He has his right hip turned just a little bit more towards the target than you do. But you've made such a tremendous progress here. That's really, really good.